As new beginner in the industry, if we need to install a new three-phase motor or replace a three-phase motor on a machine. First we have to read its nameplate, and see the motor specifications. If we see the nameplate of the motor, motor operating voltage is mentioned on it. As a new beginner it is sometime confusing, you can see that there are two voltage ratings are mentioned. First is 220 to 240 volts, and second one is 380 to 415 volts. The rated amperes are also mentioned under both voltage ratings. You can see that this motor will draw 5.90 amperes to 650 amperes maximum at 220 volt AC input supply. On the other hand, this same motor will draw 3.40 to 3.75 amperes at 380 to 415 voltage AC input supply. Other important thing is the star, delta motor wiring configuration. If you look, D is mentioned near to the 220 to 240 voltage ratings. Here D means delta configuration. This means that motor wiring should have to be in delta configuration if we want to run this motor on 240 volts AC supply. On the other hand, if you look at the 380 to 415 voltage ratings, Y is mentioned near to it. Here Y means star configuration. This means that motor wiring should have to be in star configuration if we want to run this motor on 380 to 415 volts AC supply. Now the next question that comes in mind is that, in which wiring configuration, we have to wire the motor winding coils, and how we can set the wiring configuration of three-phase motor in delta or star configuration. In today's session we will learn all this. Before going further into this video tutorial, I would like to request you guys to please subscribe this channel and press the bell icon for more upcoming video tutorials. You can see on the voltmeter that our AC supply is 400 volts. If we open the motor connection terminal, here you can see the terminal block.
Wires from the motor winding coils U, V, and W are connected here.
U1, V1, and W1 wires are connected at one side terminal block, and U2, V2 and W2 wires are connected at the other side of the terminal block. If you look closely, these wires are connected in a special sequence on these terminals. By connecting motor wires in this sequence on these terminals, it is easy to change the motor winding configuration from star to delta or from delta to star.
These are the ends of the three coils of the motor windings connected to the terminals in this arrangement. So basically we have three coils of windings inside the motor, U, V and W, with inductance L1, L2 and L3 respectively. If we connect U1 end of the red coil with the W2 end of the blue coil and W1 end of the blue coil with the V2 end of the yellow coil and V1 end of the yellow coil with the U2 end of the red coil, connection will look like a triangle, and this is called as delta winding configuration. Now if we connect the three ends of the all three coils, it will look like this. This is a star configuration.
As we have 400 volt AC supply voltage, and you can see on the motor nameplate, if we want to run the motor at 400 volts, we have to set the motor winding configuration in the star configuration. Now to set the motor winding configuration in the star configuration, we have to short one end of all three coils of the motor winding with the copper links provided with the motor. So, we will short U2, V2, and W2 terminals with copper links. This will set motor winding configuration in the star connection. Next we will connect three-phase AC supply coming from the output of the motor starter at U1, V1, and W1 terminals. Now motor is ready to run safely. Now we will see another case, where we have another motor with different voltage ratings. You can see that there are two voltage ratings mentioned on its nameplate. First is 380 to 415 volts, and second one is 660 to 690 volts. If you look at the 415 voltage ratings, D is mentioned near to the 415 voltage ratings. Here D means delta configuration. This means that motor wiring should have to be in delta configuration if we want to run this motor on 400 volts AC supply. On the other hand, if you look at the 660 to 690 voltage ratings, Y is mentioned near to it. Here Y means star configuration. This means that motor wiring should have to be in start configuration if we want to run this motor on 690 volts AC supply. Since we have 400 AC supply volts, we have to change its winding configuration to delta connections. Let's change the winding configuration of this motor to delta connections. First, we will remove all the connections and the copper links. Next, we will short U1 and W2 terminals by connecting a copper link on these terminals. Similarly, we short V1 and U2 in the last W1 and V2 terminals. Now the motor winding configuration is in the delta connection. Next, we will connect 3-phase AC supply coming from the output of the motor starter at U1, V1, and W1 terminals. Now motor is ready to run safely. That's the end of the today's tutorial. I hope you like it. Please share, like, and subscribe this channel. Till next time, take care and goodbye.